Volume 2 of the Egoist Bible, the Blue Lock character book, has just been released, and within its pages we find an interview with Blue Lock's writer Miyuki Kaneshiro and artist Yusuke Nomura. And while I was reading this interview, one section in particular jumped out to me. And with thanks to Hoshi 801 for providing the translations here. Nomura mentions that no one has noticed yet, but the numbers floating around the aura that Sai is emitting actually have meaning. Kaneshiro then chimes in. It's a sequence of meaningful numbers, and that sequence is rising to the surface. I won't say any more about it. That, of course, piqued my curiosity, and I just had to investigate. Now, I think I found some tantalizing answers that shed new light on Sai's character, so much so that I felt compelled to put out this video. Hello, my name is Sean, and for someone who's not mathematically inclined in the slightest, it's bizarre that this is my second Blue Lock and Math video. Also, if you like what I do and are interested in my thoughts on the new Blue Lock chapter every week, or just want to support the channel, go check out my Patreon page, link in the description below. Anyways, what's the deal with those numbers? Fortunately, some of my best friends have degrees in maths and physics, so I sent out a text and got an answer within a matter of minutes. It's the Fibonacci sequence. In case you aren't familiar, the Fibonacci sequence is a series of numbers where each following number is the sum of the two previous numbers. You start with 1 and 1, and then add them together to make 2. So next is 2 plus 1, making 3. Then we put 3 and 2 together, equals 5. 5 and 3 makes 8, and so on and so forth. Just check it out. Here's a shot of Sai with his numeric aura, and right there are the numbers of the Fibonacci sequence. Let me add some color to make it a bit clearer. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, etc. This is the sequence in every shot where Sai is shown with his unique aura, over and over again. Now, I figure many of you might be thinking, sure, those are them numbers, but why does any of that matter? The short answer is basically that the Fibonacci sequence is closely related to something called the golden ratio, which was hailed as the so-called divine proportion during the Renaissance. It's a ratio that many throughout history have considered the perfect embodiment of mathematical beauty. So yeah, not hard to see why this would be relevant to Sai's brand of beautiful destruction. That's all you need to know, really. Sai Itoshi's football is immaculately beautiful because it's performed with mathematical precision, and that is underpinned by depicting him with a sequence that has been claimed to embody the regular, harmonic, and even divine order of the cosmos. If that's all you want to know, you can click away now, because for the rest of the video, I'll be providing the mathematical and historical background to substantiate my claims about Sai's aura. Okay, so if you're still here, I figure you're excited to dive into the weeds for 10 minutes or so. And just for transparency, I've derived most of the information in this section from two books. Gary Meisner's The Golden Ratio, The Divine Beauty of Mathematics, and Mario Livio's The Story of Phi, The World's Most Astonishing Number. The term golden ratio is used for a unique ratio where the sum of two quantities is the same as the size of the larger quantity. That's a bit abstract, so let me visualize the idea for you. Here's a line which I will call A. Now, I've divided this line perfectly in the middle, and I'll call the two halves B and C. This means that the ratio between A and B, or A and C for that matter, is 2, since A is twice as large as B and C. Meanwhile, the ratio between B and C is 1, since they're both equally large. Now, there's one point where it can intersect the line to get a ratio between A and B that is exactly the same as that between B and C. For this, I need to introduce a value we call phi. phi is an irrational number, similar to pi, which you're probably familiar with, and its value is approximately 1.618. In case you want a precise definition, phi equals 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2. And yes, this is a video about a football comic. The other unique quality of phi is that it's the only number where 1 divided by that value is identical to its value minus 1. And that's very relevant for this whole story about the golden ratio. So let's draw another line A with the length of 1 and divide it into another two lines B and C at the point phi minus 1. So that's approximately at point 0.618. And here's what makes this one point unique. The ratio between A and the larger half B equals phi, meaning about 1.618. But if we then look at the ratio between the two halves B and C, which are approximately 0.618 and 0.382, we get the exact same value. B is also 1.681 times larger than C. That means we can keep repeating this process infinitely. If we were to divide line B into two halves with the same relative proportions, the longer half would equal the length of line C, and then the remaining half D would stand in the same relation to C as C does to B, etc. Now, let me step away from the maths for a second. This proportion had already been identified by ancient Greek mathematicians, most prominently by Euclid. However, it's only during the Renaissance that this proportion was explicitly transposed from mathematical tomes to the realm of aesthetics. The Franciscan friar Luca Pacioli set out in his 1509 book Divina Proporzione, The Divine Proportion, that, well, this proportion is divine. Also, fun fact, this text was illustrated by none other than Leonardo da Vinci. Anyways, Pacioli's reasoning for considering the golden ratio divine are steeped in Catholic theology. There is only one ratio with this property, just like there is only one God. And yet, that ratio is comprised of three units. Our lines A, B, and C, just as the Holy Trinity consists of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And then there's the fact that phi is an irrational number, a value that can't be fully approximated in human notation, just as how God is incomprehensible to the human mind. Pacioli's ideas didn't seem to have come completely out of the blue, however. We can observe a keen interest in this ratio among Renaissance artists even before the publication of Divina Proporzione. Just have a look at this painting from the 1470s, The Annunciation by Leonardo da Vinci. Its central lines, both horizontally and vertically, are almost perfect embodiments of the golden ratio, which comes together at this focal point that stands at 0.618 from both the bottom and the right. I could list some more examples, but I'm very much aware that this video is bloated enough as is. But it's really cool how many famous Renaissance paintings seem to apply the golden ratio. So let's finally bring the Fibonacci sequence into this. As you see in this table, the ratio of each successive pair in the Fibonacci sequence converges on the value of phi, meaning the further you go in the sequence, the more similar the values get. Moreover, you can approximate numbers in the Fibonacci sequence using phi with the following equation. Take phi to the power of the number you're trying to find, and divide this by the square root of 5. So, say you want to know the 10th Fibonacci number. Your formula is phi to the power of 10 divided by the square root of 5, which gives 55.00364. And 55 is indeed the 10th value in the sequence. I'm glad to be supplying all these new insights into Blue Lock, by the way. Now, chances are you've come across the golden ratio specifically in the form of these Fibonacci spirals. The basic idea of this is that we've got a series of squares spiraling outwards, with each square having the size of the next number in the Fibonacci sequence. That, of course, means that the ratio between each successive pair converges ever closer to phi. So if we, for example, take the squares size 13 and 8, the ratio between them is relatively close to our familiar 1.618. Then, draw a logarithmic spiral across each of the squares, and you'll get something that looks like this. So why is this of any interest? From the 18th century onwards, we get this surge of fascination with the golden ratio from an unexpected avenue, the natural sciences. Naturalists started seeing proportions everywhere in the world around us that seemed to resemble the golden ratio. From the arrangement of leaves in plants, to the shell of a nautilus, up to, in more recent times, the shape of hurricanes, and even entire galaxies. I do have to flag, however, that all of this has been disputed by modern scholars, and I'm absolutely not equipped to weigh in about whether any of these observations have a basis in material reality. Either way, though, the idea that this golden ratio is some kind of natural constant firmly took root in the imagination of 19th century scholars. For instance, the German psychologist Adolf Ziesing proclaimed that this proportion amounted to a universal law that represents an ideal in all structures and all forms of life. As Gary Meisner puts it, Ziesing proclaimed that the golden ratio was an expression of beauty and completeness in both nature and art. This idea that in the golden ratio we have an objective universal expression of beauty caught on and still persists to this very day. Mario Livio lists in his book a whole slew of attempted experiments conducted in the previous century that sought to demonstrate that humans are predisposed with an aesthetic preference for the golden ratio and shapes contained in that, the vast majority of which didn't substantiate this hypothesis in the slightest, by the way. Nevertheless, the idea still persists in the cultural consciousness. The notion that there exists some hidden, underlying mathematical structure to life, the universe, and everything apparently appeals to a great number of folks. So here ends your whistle-stop tour about the Fibonacci sequence and the golden ratio. So let's get back to Blue Lock. Sai Itoshi is surrounded by the integers of the Fibonacci sequence because they're closely interwoven with the golden ratio, a proportion that has been made out as a divine expression of perfect beauty. Now, last but not least, because I bet some of you might have been wondering, can we find this golden ratio reflected in any of the panels with Sai's numerical aura? I tried it out in all kinds of panels in the U20 match, and the answer is mostly no. However, there is one tantalizing instance where I've found two ways to make it work. And significantly enough, this is the panel that first names the concept of beautiful destruction. Firstly, I overlaid a golden ratio grid over the panel here. And note how the top of Hiyori's body and the bottom of Sai's converge almost perfectly at the golden ratio point. And if you're willing to accept something that's even more of a stretch, Sai's torso ends almost exactly on the right side of the horizontal line, the horizontal golden ratio line, and his legs close to that on the left hand. But more than that, look at what happens if I add a Fibonacci spiral on top of Sai here. You get a really nice curve from his hairline to his knees converging on the ball. And listen, I'm the first to admit that if you just keep laying grids on top of Blue Lock panels, you'll eventually get a false positive. But I don't know, I like to believe that Nomura was given mathematical perfection a shot of his own with the moment where Sai's football philosophy is finally revealed. So that's it for me. This wasn't a video I was planning to make, but I got super excited about the topic and thought it'd be fun. So here you go. This also means I haven't made much progress at all on the video I've actually been meaning to make the past few days. So that'll most likely get delayed a bit longer than I'd hoped for. Anyways, I'd be very curious to see what your thoughts about all this are, and as always, look forward to chatting with you in the comments. And if you liked what you saw, consider subscribing for more in-depth Blue Lock analysis every other week, and maybe even join my Patreon for my weekly thoughts on the new Blue Lock chapter. And until then, slán go fall.